their teachers. I think it's one of the great opportunity for me to address on the occasion of the Teachers' Day celebration. My 3 decades of service, and today is a day we are celebrating Teachers' Day without our children. Dear teacher, on this great occasion, I salute all my teachers to whom I have learned. Also, I salute all the teachers to whom I am working. I consider the teacher is a person who can change this world. In this angle, we are approaching to this young mind. Even now, the entire nation worrying about coronas, virus, 19 and this all. Even children are being kept in the home. Almost all the parents are in the panic. What to do for this young generation? All the industries have been stopped. All the productivity has been stopped. All the research has been stopped. Even science and technology has been stopped. And only one event, even today, we have never allowed to stop. That is nothing but teaching. That is only possible because of our teacher. Though teachers, children are not with us, those children are not able to come out of the home, but still we are extending our noble service to their home through online. I must salute to all the teachers for having accepted this online teaching and reaching to their home and educating them the minimum level of teaching. But no doubt, again this another 3 months, 4 months, the same type of situation will prevail. But let us not discourage ourselves. Let us reach again to the children home through online, and we'll educate them without any gap. That's what I look forward for all the young teachers. Dear teacher, those days we always considered teaching is only inside the classroom activities. The teaching is only for delivering some lectures. Teaching is the only things we can write something in the blackboard and asking children to copy it up. Now these all the things have been minimized. Using the blackboard has become minimized. Reading the textbook has become minimized. And teaching volume and volume has become minimized. Totally the teaching methodology and modality has been changed to new era. My humble request to all the young teachers. I think we are all fortunate. KV Sivayanga has having very, very young team of teachers. I am very much requesting all the young teachers. Now your limit is beyond. When we have taken up this responsibility, when we were young age, we were thinking that entire things only within the classroom. Within the classroom. Now it's been proved, inside the classroom you can do only 10%. You cannot do more than 10% inside the classroom for these brilliant children. This generation children. Then you may ask questions, sir, what is to be done for 90%? 90% you are supposed to do only depends upon your day-to-day work. Your day-to-day work, your day-to-day behavior, your gentle behavior, your approach towards the children, your handling the children is going to be a next volume and volume of textbook for this young generation. Suppose as a science teacher, as a math teacher, if you are solving entire problem from textbook to first page to last page, I think the children never satisfy. Because even in the first page to last page textual material, the present generation children can solve without your and my support. That is the advantage of present generation children. So leaving that textual material, you should come out again to change their behavior and bringing them towards this better side. That's what we look forward. Unfortunately, present generation listen only from teacher, not from the parent. You may be experienced. Many of the parents are expressing their worries. My son is not listening from me. My daughter is not listening from me. But now he's left to only teachers. Even the parents are totally surrendering to the teachers. You are considered to be a God now. You are considered to be more than God now. Kindly bring my child as per the expectation of the society. This is the biggest demand from every parent. I think the forthcoming year, this young generation, your responsibility is going to be again threefolded and fourfolded. Those days we concentrate only inside the classrooms. Now concentrating inside the classroom merely, you cannot be a good teacher. You have to be outside the classrooms, and you have to be mold the child wherever, whenever they are, or directly or indirectly. Now the society look forward character-based citizenship. We don't want an extraordinary brilliant child who scored 100 out of 100 mark. We don't want the child all the time with his textbooks and reading. It's not going to be help us. Now it is our responsibility to give responsibility, character-based citizens in this country. You are aware now, this last 6 months, how we have been threatened for this entire bordering nations, countries. They are all jealousy on us. They are all competitive towards us. Even today morning, President of America has openly supported that I will solve the problem of China and India, I think, today morning news. Even yesterday, Russia has given open application to the India. The first we will help to India for regarding corona issue. This is what the friendly, there are countries are identifying our talented. Because the entire universe understood that the Indians are not only brilliant, but human being. The Indian children are not only brilliant with the dedicated and commitment towards the service. Now it is our responsibility to bring the dedicated children and commitment children towards this nation. Again, my humble request to all my teachers, whenever you are inside the classroom, whenever you are in the teaching, don't teach all the time in the lesson, which is not required for this young generation. If you go on teach all the lessons, I think this young generation will name you as a boring teacher. Come out of the textbook. Go with some lively examples to the children. How you have learned things from your teacher. How you have behaved with your teacher. How you have behaved with your parents. How you are expecting your children to behave. These type of that skill, life skill has to be educated for every period of your teaching period. At least for few minutes, keeping away your subject, at least for few minutes, either beginning of the session or end of the session, you must be coordinate and correlated with your value based towards the children. Then only you will find the good citizens. If you are not taking care of this generation as well characterized, again, it is going to be a big threat for us. Let us take challenge for all these teachers, community. Even the situation will be still worse in this corona issue for the forthcoming months, but still let us not give up. Let us reach to our children, let us educate our children, let our children will not feel any gap towards this education. Let us support to the parent of bringing the children in this better way. It is possible only when we open-minded teachers, you and me, are in India. So once again, I congratulate and I wish Happy Teachers Day, and every one of you having more than 25 to 30 years service left in your career. You will be remembering this Teachers Day definitely, because this is a Teachers Day we celebrate without our children. By the time you might have seen, a lot of children will be bringing the flowers, bringing the card, all the things. We are missing these children now. Definitely this Teachers Day will be remembered to you, and wherever you are, whenever you are, prepare yourself, do something for this country, do something for the children, at least for the children to whom you are able to reach, bring them as a good citizen. Definitely your service will be identified, your service will be noted for this great people. Not only for your, even your own children will be gaining with your blessing of all the parents. That's what I look forward. I think I am completing almost 30 years of my teaching career. I think one more Teacher's Day I will be celebrating. One more Teacher's Day. I worked more than 10 principals. I worked more than 50,000 teachers in Navodayas and KVs. And my way of functioning is a little bit different. So I am strict in the academic and I am a little bit liberal in this other human beings. This is the way I used to manage with that. Even today I have received a call from my first principal to whom I have joined in Navodaya Vidyalaya in Kukunur. He's almost his the last 95 years, but 95 years old man, he called me and is wishing me. Morning. Before I call, he has called me. This is what our gratitude is. So salute your teachers to whom you have learned so far. Respect them. Respect them. And the same way you have to turn to your children to whom the... Nowadays getting children are very big challenges because parents never give children in your hand. We may be thinking that there is no other way the children are coming to the school. No. Parents are looking different angle. Which school is better, which teacher is good teacher, and which principal is doing good job. Everything is being noticed. Now hereafter, your service is to be very, very challengeable service, and accept this profession as a noble profession and extend your service for this young generation. Definitely the Almighty will take care of you and the Almighty will take care of your family members. This is my message from this great occasion. Once again, I wish you a very, very happy Teacher's Day. Thank you so much for listening to my speech. Thank you.
आदरणीय सभी गुरुजन और मेरे प्यारे विद्यार्थियों, आज हम शिक्षक दिवस मना रहे हैं। सभी को पता है कि शिक्षक दिवस डॉक्टर राधा कृष्णन जी के जन्मदिन के दिन मनाया जाता है। आज मैं गुरु की बात करूं, तो जब मैं यहां आपके सामने खड़े होकर आपको संबोधित कर रही हूं, तो मुझे मेरे उन सभी गुरुजनों की याद जो मेरे दिल और दिमाग पे गहरा असर छोड़ी है, जो भी हम हमारे शिक्षकों से आज तक सीखा है, जो ज्ञान हमने प्राप्त किया है, वास्तव में वो मुझे महसूस करा रहा है, एहसास करवा रहा है कि जब हम कभी भी कठिन से कठिन परिस्थिति का सामना कर रहे होते हैं, तो हमें हमारा ज्ञान, हमारा नॉलेज, वो ही हमें एक एकनिष्ठ सहारे की रूप में हमें दिखाई देता है। क्योंकि कहा भी जाता है कि जब हमारे पास कोई संपत्ति है, कोई गोल्ड है या कोई बहुत सारे चीज़ें हैं, पैसे हैं, वो हमारे पास हमेशा नहीं रहते, क्योंकि उनका खोने का डर भी रहता है, वो चोरी भी हो सकते हैं। लेकिन एजुकेशन, ज्ञान, शिक्षा कभी भी चोरी नहीं होती और कभी भी कम नहीं होती। एक दोहा मुझे याद आ रहा है, माँ सरस्वती के भंडार की बड़ी अपूर्व बात, जो खर्चे त्यों त्यों बड़े, बिन खर्चे घट जाए। अर्थात माँ सरस्वती का ज्ञान एक ऐसा ज्ञान है, शिक्षा एक ऐसी चीज है जो हम किसी को देते हैं तो वो बढ़ती है, कभी भी खर्च नहीं होती, कभी भी कम नहीं होती। और जब गुरु की बात की जाए तो गुरु ईश्वर के समान है, और गुरु के लिए मैंने एक दोहा जो मेरा खुद का रचित दोहा है, गुरु ही ज्ञान देता है, गुरु ही पाख देता है, गुरु ही साख देता है, और वह भी गुरु ही होता है जो कर राख देता है। शायद किसी को अच्छा नहीं लगे, लेकिन ये मेरे खुद के भाव हैं, तो मैं बता रही हूँ कि वास्तव में गुरु की ऐसी भूमिका होती है हमारे जीवन में, एक गुरु की, टीचर की ऐसी भूमिका होती है, ऐसी जिम्मेदारी होती है गुरु के हाथ में, एक चिल्ड्रन को लेके, एक बच्चे को लेके, अपने स्टूडेंट को लेके, कि वह बच्चे को बहुत बड़ा आदमी भी बना सकता है, और अगर गुरु का व्यवहार या गुरु की भूमिका उसने अच्छे से ना निभाई हो तो वह सब कुछ राख भी कर देता है। इसलिए मैं सभी गुरुजनों से, जो नव चयनित गुरुजी हैं, उनसे निवेदन करूंगी कि वो गुरु पहले वाली पंक्ति वाला गुरु बने, ना कि दूसरी पंक्ति वाला गुरु। ऐसा मेरा मानना है, और मेरा यही मानना है कि जो भी जिम्मेदारी है उसको हमें अच्छे से निभानी चाहिए। विद्यार्थी जीवन में सबसे बड़ी जिम्मेदारी है सीखते रहना। विद्यार्थी जीवन ही नहीं, हमारी लाइफ टाइम, पूरे समय, हमारा जीवन भर हम अगर सीखते रहेंगे, कुछ ना कुछ प्राप्त करते रहेंगे, स्कूल टीचर्स ही नहीं, कोई भी लाइफ में हमें जो भी कुछ भी सिखाता है उससे हम जब सीखते रहेंगे, हमारे ज्ञान को बढ़ाते रहेंगे, तो वो ही हमारा पता नहीं कब किस कठिन परिस्थिति में अंतिम क्षण हमें काम आ जाए। यही मेरे विचार हैं और विद्यार्थियों से आज का मैसेज यही है कि वो सीखते रहें, अपने नॉलेज को बढ़ाते हैं, कभी भी सीखना बंद ना करें, सीखना कभी भी बंद नहीं करना चाहिए, हमेशा सीखते रहना चाहिए। इतना कहकर मैं अपने शब्दों को विराम देती हूँ, धन्यवाद। और सभी को अंत में कहना चाहूँगी कि उनको उज्जवल भविष्य की शुभकामनाएं, शिक्षक दिवस की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं।